These days, people are obsessed with water bottles. I think I have like a dozen branded water bottles on my desk from races and from work and from all sorts of stuff, but I never use them. Am I dehydrated? How would I know? Hey everybody, Trace here for D News. Thanks for tuning in. We did a video a while back about how much water we should be drinking that said we sometimes drink too much water. According to widely reported data published by the Associated Press in 2013, we're drinking 58 gallons of water per year, or about 2.5 cups a day, and that is a lot. Way more than we did in the 90s, so feel good about that, when soda topped the beverage list. But as long as we don't overdo it, it's probably better that we drink a little more water than a little less. Water helps balance the chemicals that keep your body working. It fills our cells, it helps regulate our body temperature by respiration and sweating, it flushes waste, forms saliva to intake fuel, lubricates our joints, cushions our spinal cord and brain, and carbohydrates and proteins are metabolized and transported by water in our blood. You commonly hear that we are 75% water, but different organs are different percentages of water. The brain is 73%, for example. Skin is a little less at 64% water, and muscles and kidneys are a little more at 79% water. Bones, however, are only 31%. We can survive for weeks without food, but only a few days without water. During sports, athletes can lose 6 to 10% of body weight simply from loss of water. It's important to drink when you feel thirsty, but don't push fluids on people. A study in the Journal of Applied Physiology found a 15% reduced muscle endurance rate during dehydration, but no effect on overall muscle strength. Water does not alleviate muscle cramps, it does not stop heat stroke, and too much can cause hyponatremia, or a dilution of salt in the blood, which can result in death. That said, even mild dehydration, like a 1.5% drop in water, can mess with focus, alertness, and short-term memory, which is why you should drink water before a test at school and during rigorous exercise. Even conditioned athletes who were mildly dehydrated scored highly in fatigue, confusion, anger, and vigor on a subjective mood score. Chronic dehydration puts people at risk for type 2 diabetes, cancer, high blood pressure, and obesity. A study in physiology and behavior found that hypohydration, aka dehydration, can cause increased error rates while driving and altered mood states in men, and another study with women found while they don't experience diminished cognitive function, they do see increases in fatigue, tension, and anxiety. And that's all just the mild stuff, guys. Excessive dehydration is when things get really serious. As full dehydration sets in and the body realizes water is not being replaced, it's going to stop sweating, stop urinating, and attempt to conserve as much water as it can. This causes the blood to thicken, which in turn causes increased blood pressure. The heart has to pump harder to push that sludgy blood around the body, and cholesterol increases as the water is lost from cells. Ultimately, the heart suffers and chances of cardiac arrest increase, and the cognitive impairment that I mentioned, that worsens. It's pretty unlikely for this to happen while playing sports, of course, because eventually you have to stop. But as we get older, the body's thirst mechanism worsens, increasing the risk of dehydration without even knowing you are dehydrated. If you're worried about dehydration, the best thing to do is pay attention to your fluid intake and how much you're sweating. Sweat allows the body to cool, so as dehydration sets in, the body will get increasingly warm and yet sweat less. Sweat also contains electrolytes, which are salts and minerals it needs to survive, like sodium and potassium. If you're drinking water on an empty stomach, it can be absorbed through the intestine and hit the bloodstream in less than 5 minutes. But if you've eaten, it can take as long as 45 and all the way up to 120 minutes to fully digest the water. Drinking water and/or sports drinks during and after vigorous activity can help the body recover from all that fluid loss and help you cool off, even right away. But as long as we're talking about cool, Toyota has been doing some really cool stuff with the TRD line of Toyota trucks, enhanced to rule the off-road. If you want to know more about how much water you should be drinking, make sure you check out this video from a little while ago about how many glasses of water we drink every day and whether that's even the right amount. A lot of our fluid intake comes from food. The rules say that we need to drink fluid. So if we eat a banana or an orange, we consume their fluid, which is to say, we take their water. Let us know what you think about this video and if you have any science questions down in the comments, and subscribe so you get more D News every day of your life.